Okay, we're back at the car. We're going to put the IAC in now.
Just basically the opposite of the way we did it before. First things you want to connect is you put it in, are the two coolant lines, then you can line everything else up, get everything all in place. So this coolant line is always a little bit of a bugger, because it's so short, so we kind of like to get that one in first. Now, since they use a regular hose clamp on that instead of a spring clamp, I got to use what they put on there. I don't want to take these clamps off yet, because by me doing that, it will go into the IAC and come out the other side and still make a mess. So I want to continue to keep those on there until I get the other hose on. As soon as I put the other hose on, I'll pop those clamps off. That one's on. The other one has spring clamps, so we can just put that on. Find my pliers. That's on. So now that those two hoses are on, thank you. Okay, now I'm going to try to just get this laid in position. I'm going to hook up the throttle cable. If we have room or slack on the throttle chamber. Okay. Now we'll put the 12 millimeter bolts in. Try to line that up the gasket there. Bottom one has a bracket. I think it's a bracket to be where the bottom 12 millimeter is. At the same time, if you like, you can plug the TPS in, because we're pretty much in there that way. Okay. Okay. Oh, you gotta plug that IAC in. Okay, we got all our bolts started. So I can zip down that throttle chamber now. Okay. Throttle chamber's now in. IAC's in place. Coolant lines put in place and tightened. IAC's plugged in, TPS is plugged in. Now we just gotta put the airbox back in, then we'll be doing the ECM. Line this up, get your hose in place, push so you feel pop in. Now, these guys, you got vacuum lines over here. This garage left these unplugged by the looks of it. I don't know why, but how you touch them. Set our vacuum lines back on over here. as again. Okay. So I have screwdriver, tighten the clamp, or an 8mm socket, whichever you prefer. These are all 10mm bolts. We have one 10mm that goes down past the battery here, behind the battery, so don't forget that one. This is the fender. These sometimes break when you pop them off. They came on his own.
That's it for the IAC. Next, we'll be doing the ECM. Thank you.